Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, we will be creating responsive table using Bootstrap 4. If you are interested to see a demo of this tutorial, then feel free to check the link in the description below. Or, if you want to download the project, then I have added them in my GitHub account. You can see the link in the description below. So, this is the basic responsive table created with the help of Bootstrap 4. If you resize the browser width, then you can see the horizontal scroll bar and we are able to scroll it from left to right. Also, I have added tooltip with a message called bad weather condition. I want to add them whenever the flight status is cancelled. Now let's get started. I have index.html along with main.css and main.js. I have also added Google font called Oxygen to get started. Next thing I want to do is I want to add Bootstrap CSS just before this main.css. I will use CDN method. So I will grab the CDN link from Bootstrap website. Open the Bootstrap website. Click on Get Started. And then copy this CDN link. And paste it over here. You can write a comment if you want. Now, we'll be able to add Bootstrap responsive table. Let's copy the HTML code from the website. Click on the content. Click on tables. Then on right hand side, you can see list of link with different table styles like border table, small table, responsive table and many more. Among all of them, I want to click with the one called responsive table. Then on top hand side, we can see the design of the table and on bottom side, we can see the HTML code. You can simply copy this code and paste it in your index.html. Here we can add some table data. So you can click on examples and then copy the code starting from table head to the end of table body. After that, we will see table design just like this one. If you want to put this table at the center, just like this one, then we have to add a div with a class called container just outside this table responsive class. Refresh the page, and also if you want some margin top, then we can add empty dash some number, for example 5. You can refresh the page. Then let's add some heading called flight status. So just before table responsive class, I will use S3 tag and the name of the heading is flight status. Refresh. If you want to center this text, then you can add the class called text center. Also, if you want some margin bottom, then you can add mb dash some number. So now if we look at the design of the table, we can see that there are some borders, some hover effect in the table, and some backgrounds. So the border of the table can be obtained from this border table, and we simply have to add this class name called table border in this table tag. So let's add that class name. So after table, you can add table bordered. Refresh the page. So this is done. Then second thing is we need the hover effect on the table, so it can be added from this hoverable rows, I think. So yeah this is the one. So for that one, we have to add the class name table hover. So that is done as well. And the final one is we have to add the background, so that can be done using this stripe rows. So this is the one. So you simply have to add the class name called table striped. You can add the class name and then you can just refresh the page, and yeah, some of the design are done. Now I want to use black background and white text in this table heading. So I want to click on this contextual classes, and then if you want the light version of the color, then you can use the class name that begins with table primary, table secondary, and so on. Or if you want the darker version, then you can use the class called BG primary, BG success, and so on. So I'll be using class called BG dark over here because I want a darker version. So the background is now black, and if you want to make the white text, then you can write text white class over there, and you will get a white text over there. Now our table design looks somewhat similar to the actual design, but before working on other things like tooltip, I want to change table data in my HTML. I will copy and paste the new table data. Now I want to add red background whenever the status is cancelled. So I can simply go to my TD and add a class called busy danger. And if you want the white text, you can add text white class. Now, if you want to add more padding in this TD, then you have to override the Bootstrap's CSS into your main.css. So you can just copy this class name and you can define the padding. I will write 20px. Refresh. Now everything looks same except the tooltip, so let's work on it now. Here you can search tooltips and then you can add tooltip on the left hand side. So I will copy this code and paste it over here. And then I will update the message called bad weather condition over here. Now, if you refresh the page and hover in the cancelled, you might see that it is not working because tooltip requires some additional JavaScript. So you have to open the Bootstrap site again. You can click on the main page, click on get started, and then you have to copy all these JS files. You can add everything just before this main.js file. So the first one is just a jQuery library, so I'll just call it jQuery CDN. The second one is popper.js, so this JS is required for the tooltip, and the third one is bootstrap.js. So this JS is also required if you work on the JavaScript thing. Again, you can click on the tooltip, and then the final thing you have to do is you have to add this code in this main.js, and this will be td because we are adding tooltip in this td tag, and then it can just be blank. So now if you refresh this page, the tooltip is working. The last thing we need to work is to change the background color of tooltip from black to red. We have to use custom CSS to achieve that, and we need to know the HTML structure too. If I try to see HTML structure using developer tool, it's hard for me to see because as soon as I hover out, tooltip div will go missing at the bottom. You can see over here. So we can know HTML structure from two ways. First way is from Bootstrap site itself. If you go to the Bootstrap site and if you scroll down, you can see the HTML structure over here. Or the second way is to add a show method in main.js, which is this one. So basically we have to add this show like this. So it means that the tooltip will always be visible, so that I can check the structure now. I can open the developer tool, and you can see this div is now always open, and I have to change the background in this tooltip inner class. So I will just copy this div and I'll open main.css. And the background I want is the red one, so I will just copy this background code and add it over here. Refresh. So the next thing is I want to change the background of that small arrow as well. So that small arrow is coming from this before pseudo element. So I can just copy this one and before, and that is the border color, so I will use that border left color, and I will apply the same color and try to refresh the page again. It's not working, so I might have to use the parent class, which is the tooltip. So I will use at the beginning and refresh again, and yeah, you can see it is working now. So at last, when everything is fine, you can remove this method again and refresh the page. Now when you hover over there, you can see the tooltip in red background. Also, when I resize the browser width, it is showing the horizontal scroll bar for me. Perfect! Everything is working now. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.